guys, and well, yes, welcome back to yes another video. And today we are going to do my cosplay that I did back in Halloween 2019. And as you can see, I'm doing a silver marker onto the button to make the jeans like official. That was originally black, the button, but I just said I just would just like a leather type of button, so I just said I'd cover it so it looks professional. So the pants was about 10 euros and it was a hard fabric to cut through actually, because it was hard to actually measure. So it still looks good though, I guess, in some sense, when you see the results as you keep going along in this video. But I'm sad to say that Arts and Hobby have actually shut down Italy, and it's a loss to me because literally they helped me through a lot of my cosplay. They knew I was Harley Quinn, they knew I was Spider-Gwen. I'm sad to say they didn't see my Cheryl Blossom, but hopefully when they see this video they will, but I doubt it. But I'm just shocked that it closed down, because I got most of my cosplay and stuff in there. And if I was stuck on anything, like, the staff were so nice. They'd help me out and say what was right for my makeup or like the face paint or just any type of creative thing that I had my inspiration on that I didn't know how to create it, like visually, if I was doing it right or if there was another thing I could do it perfectly. They would have the advice for that. And I'm just absolutely devastated that shops are closing down in Tralee, and that is one of them, and I will miss them. They were a sponsor for Kingdom Comic Fest, and it's a loss to lose one of our sponsors. So now we go on to the vintage shop that Cheryl wears. So this scene is in season 2. This outfit is inspired by Riverdale season 2. And it's a special one because it's when Cheryl gets her red jacket. You will see at the very, very end of what the results look like. But if you are a Riverdale fan, you already know what this is going to turn out like. But I will not show you the results of this whole outfit until the 8th of March at Gamerfest Limerick, and the 14th and the 15th of March in Dublin Comic Con for the week of my birthday. And I cannot wait for those events, because it's the first time I ever get to show this very like new cosplay that I have. And literally, the interesting part about this top is that the collar is actually stitched. The collar is a headband that I got in Icon. It was only about 2 euros, and I just asked someone to stitch it for me. And when I seen the top and pennies, I was like, that looks identical to Cheryl's type of style, so it's vintage. So, and then I'm just going to put like, I put it like a black like long sleeve top underneath that, so it looked like a whole one like top for the costume. And the gems weren't that bad, but as you can see, I got Bostic glue and I glued each one, and I'm looking at a picture of Cheryl Blow on my phone, so to keep it focused and get the proper design for the collar of the gems. And literally, there was a lot of cleaning, there was a lot of glue, and it's the worst glue I ever had to do in my whole entire life. It was so sticky and so messy, but you know, you gotta do it when you're creative. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did creating it. Don't forget to smash that like button, hit that subscribe button so you won't miss any of my videos each week. And of course, don't forget to hit those notifications right there. And I shall see you guys for the next video. And as I said, the results will be shown as just in a couple of minutes at the very end of this video, if you know what I'm talking about.
For this dream in my soul.